Hi, welcome to Robojax. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can build this case for the DS0138 oscilloscope. The protection of the case is very important because all the components are exposed and anytime they can get damaged. So this is a nice protection, a nice case. So let's get started. So for this oscilloscope, I also bought something called a case for this. So it's laser cut pieces. So this doesn't have any instruction or anything. So I have cleared them all from the protective sheet. The first thing, remove the monitor, the one that has this shape cut for all the pieces. So this goes here and make sure that you can fit it properly or move some of the parts that are on the place. Just bend them a little so this can fit properly. Then after that, we just put this here and make sure that we use one of these small tiny screws from not from this side. Now the four screw, the nuts are on this side and the screws are on here. Now let's insert this top piece. So the monitor is inserted from all sides. So the switches are not on the hole. Now they are here. Now take two of these. They're the same, exactly the same. Just put them, they are spacers. So on one side, when these lines are long, these are for the sliding switches. And the one that on this side are for these normal switches. Just put them here. You might receive it as one piece, just break them. And five of these push button switches will go here. Then we have three switches, so these sliders are for the switches, and the one that has small notch here, so this will go to the bottom, and make sure that you insert it in the switch so this grabs the switch. So if I hold this up and push the switches, they should work fine. And also if I slide this a little, make sure, yes, you can do it. So at this stage, just put the, hold this with hand, and then put the nut here. Once you put the nut, align it to the hole and then insert the screw from the top. Now I can just hold this with my one finger and then tighten this. Now if you see it here, I'm tightening it, or hold it with a finger and then tighten it. So the same thing for all four. This switch already seems to be depressed. These screws here before I tighten the top piece. So this will hold the PCB for me. So on this side, this switch is already depressed, so meaning I have to fix it. So I'm removing this tiny piece here. I'm removing this and this, and then opening this. And then I'm gonna open this one again. Holding that screw nut. So I will open it only as much as I can enter the nut there. Okay, that's enough. Now I'm inserting another nut here. So I have two nuts, this nut and this nut. So I will tighten this. Okay, so now I'm holding this nut to tighten this first, and then testing this switch. So if the switch works fine, then I am tightening or opening it so it comes this way. Now this will hold this PCB, so it cannot be pressed. So there is no way it can be pressed. So the switch now works perfect. Let me test these other switches. They are all working. Inserting this one, and this hole is for that test point that we have beside the power. So make sure that you understand that, and then insert it here. And then this piece should be inserted into the lower bottom. Now after that, I'm going to insert this one. These two are closer, these two are far apart. This side will go here. So making sure that this also goes in it. And same thing here, these two pieces that are far apart will go here. This went without an issue. Same thing here, these two that are far apart will go down, these two are closer, they go up. Now I have to push the other side so away, so I have enough room. So all of them have been inserted and sitting properly, and this is the last piece. So the last piece just fits easily, and I have here longer port and those are small, shorter. No, all of them, when they fit, they look nice. so. Now let's put these screws here before I tighten the top piece. So this will hold the PCB for me. I have so this is the 6mm nut driver. Not much. I'm not tightening them because I'm worried that it might break. So there is a space now. This fit also here. So that is good. So okay, that's good. So that is a 6 kHz. So let me show you the data again. So this was how to assemble the casing for the DS0138. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, please share it, and also subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.